Well, Surgeon Dr. M. Iglani is there, and today I am here to demonstrate about this basic laparoscopic camera head basically. So this is the close-up view, and this is whole is the camera head. Basically it is composed of basically two parts. So here this part, I am going to remove this part very gently. So I have disengaged two parts, and this is basically CCD, that's a charged coupled device, and basically this has got the lens, and if you are able to see it in a closer view, that greenish chip is there. It is the one chip camera basically, and this is known as the optical coupler. And if you closely see this, on the both the sides there are lenses are there. On the other side, this is also lens. This device, it is known as coupler because it couples the camera CCD with the telescope. That's it. After that, I will show you. Okay. And if you consider this as the retina of the eye, and this is the pupil of the eye. And so I am going to connect it in front of you, and always be very gentle. So I am just assembling it. Finally, I have assembled it in a very beautiful way. So after that, you will press it fully. You will press it fully and put it here, and it will be attached. So now you might have understood that it is coupling that this telescope with this CCD. That's why it is known as the optical coupler. And this point, basically you will focus that. And there are four buttons are there. If I am able to focus this, if you are clearly seeing that, on one button there is written P, another button there is written W. One is the for the white balance. Again, I am holding this, and very gently you will take the light cable here into the light adapter, very gently at this point, like this. After that, you will hold it like this. There should be gap between your two fingers, and again your thumb should be free, and your this optical cable, light source cable, should be between your fingers, so it does not move like this, like this, or you don't hold it like this, otherwise it will fall and it will cause trouble for you. It might get damaged. So your this thumb should be free to adjust the white balance and other things. Okay. At this point, I must tell you that there are two camera systems which are used in the laparoscopy. This which I am using, that's the one chip camera system, and other is the three chip camera system, in which three chips are there for the separate three colors. That's the red, blue and the green. All the colors, you must be knowing that they are made up of the only these three colors. And three chip camera, it is the better camera. Whenever blood comes, then this camera, it all goes blind and you are in the trouble. So for better vision, you must use the three chip camera, which adjusts the white balance, which adjusts the color. Better colors are there and better visibility is there, and definitely when better visibility is there, you can operate better. Now here I am going to demonstrate you the very basic setting, that's the white balancing of the camera system. For that purpose, you will be having the white object in front of the camera, so whole of your screen, it is covered with the white object. After that, you will press the W button on your camera head. So now I am pressing it, the white button, and finally at the end, white balance is complete. So that's how we do the white balancing before starting any sort of surgery. Remember one thing, don't press the W button, that's the white balance button, inside the abdomen of the patient. Otherwise white balance will be disturbed and it will cause trouble for you. So turn off the camera. How will you disengage? First of all, remove the light source very gently. After that, press this very fully and remove this. It will disengage. Just isko sambhalo. And finally at the end, this is the camera head. After that, very gently you will arrange this into the box. So thank you so much. So finally, at the end, there are some manual settings in the camera, and it's different from the for the stereoscopy and the laparoscopy. Sometimes auto mode don't work better. So at the end, if you have to use the manual mode, so first setting, first of all, make the table, and in the table, first see on one side setting, then in the middle, write the stereoscopy, and at the end, write laparoscopy. First of all, I will discuss about the brightness. In case of hysteroscopy, brightness should be set high, and in the laparoscopy, it should be kept at the minimum. And shutter speed, either you will use the auto mode. Sometimes auto mode don't work better, and it creates trouble for you. So you will set 1/50. In case of laparoscopy, you will again set either auto, and if the auto don't works for you, then set at 1/1000. And finally at the end, the fibroscopic filter is there, or the fibroscope filter. In case of hysteroscopy, you will turn it on. It works just like in the sea or in the river, and you are taking the videos, and all the dirty water, it looks very clean, and it removes all the dirty details. In case of laparoscopy, fibroscope filter should be turned off. So this is the very much conclusion. So thank you so much. Hope you have understood something.